This week on Outdoor Bound TV, it's off to Texas for a midwinter hunting trip in the Rolling Plains region of that state. Now, it's not whitetails that we're after on this trip. We'll be chasing another species that has made this part of Texas famous with upland game bird hunters from all over the U.S. For this trip to Texas, we've got our sights set on Bob White Quail.
What a fish.
There we go.
Can you believe that? It's just fantastic.
Outdoor Bound TV is brought to you by Mission by Matthews and Vortex Optics.
I'm going to be just like my dad. Strong like him, smart like him. And now that I have my Mission Menace, I'm going to be a bow hunter just like he is. This bow is my beginning, my future. This is my mission.
Featuring an advanced perimeter weighted dual cam system, the Mission Menace provides power for the hunt and adjustability to fit any beginner, young or old. Visit missionarchery.com to find an authorized retailer near you. Mission by Matthews.
Markham's new pocket-sized handheld underwater cameras, the Recon 5 and 5 Plus, use a 5-inch color display to deliver superior screen detail and employ a combination of dark water LED and infrared lighting to punch through the darkness. The Recon 5 Plus adds a built-in DVR and on-screen display for critical information, previously only available on full-sized underwater viewing systems. This winter, see what you've been missing with a Recon from Markham Technologies, the undisputed leader in underwater cameras.
The new Acme Rattlemaster has a built-in echo chamber with a brass rattle that calls fish in. The body's solid brass too and won't bend or dull, and reflects fish-attracting light all over the water column. This 1-2 punch of sight and sound means you drill less holes because fish come to you. Jig it, rip it, or shake it for crappie, walleye, northern salmon, or trout, and experience multi-species action with just one bait.
Hi everyone, welcome to Outdoor Bound TV. I'm Kurt Walbeck. Now if you like upland game bird hunting, well this week you're in luck. We make a midwinter trek to the Rolling Plains area of West Texas with my friend Bill High from Bowen Lodge. Now Bill's a pretty passionate grouse hunter here in his home state of Minnesota, but when the weather turns cold, he and his wife Gail load up the dogs and they head south to chase Bob White Quail.
We're in the Rolling Plains region of Texas on the Foster Ranch. We're doing some Bob White hunting, and this is a great year for Bob Whites, and we're gonna be, we've got an evening hunt we're gonna take off, and we're gonna go be hunting. There's a whole bunch of ragweed patches over here, and we're gonna go see if we can go find some birds. Well, we were 5 minutes out of the truck. We got into our first covey. So that's usually a pretty good sign. I'm getting my GPS and electronics squared away here. You know, we don't have to run the beepers anymore, and we can find the dog so easy. Got a dog on point. Yeah, we got another covey. Two coveys in 10 minutes, not bad. Let's go. Using a old experienced dog, Jeter, who is an all-star superstar, A+, and we're using him to train. We got a young pup here, Lewis, both Northwoods bird dogs, setters out of the Houston line. And so we had some great dog work there. The pup pointed and he backed. He found a dead bird. Let's go find another cubby. The bird we killed about 30 minutes ago didn't have any feed in it. So now this one here is about half fed. So in just 30 minutes, we went from no feeding to half crops full. So let's go keep, while the feeding frenzy's on, let's go find some more birds.
Something's weird there. I mean, I've never seen him just walk off and leave him like that. And they were there, he had them. All right, let's see if he's going. Oh, he's I'm gonna give you the gun. I'm gonna take the camera.
Seems like the second bird. Is the quail calling? Laying on their back with their feet in the air. That was a nice shot of double over, a 16-month-old setter. Wasn't that great? Wow. I love these birds. Everybody's entitled to one bad habit, and hunting Bob White Quail on the rolling plains of Texas is my bad habit. Let's go find the other one.
This one's a cockbird.
And here's the cock's on the upper part. He's got the white around his beak, and the hen is got the brown around her beak. Shooting a double over a 16-month-old puppy. Go. He handled them beautifully. I'm stuck nice, just the way they're supposed to. Let's go find another covey. You know, when West Texas is turned on, I mean, everything, you know, the rains, it came at the right time, and the quail population just literally exploded. And we're here with our dogs running around pointing them. It's a great time. I gotta go find this other bird.
That bird we just shot at.
You get it?
Yeah. A really young one.
Well, there was a day that started off with about a 9-10 covey morning, and then this afternoon we ran these setters. We have an older, experienced dog here, Jeter, and a younger 16-month-old dog, Lewis. And these both come out of Northwest Bird Dogs from Sandstone, Minnesota. And I'd like to take the second to tell Betsy and Jerry Coulter, the owners and breeders of Northwoods Bird Dog Kennels, thank you for getting us such wonderful companions and bird dogs. We feel grateful to have dogs like this.
You know, it really is a lot of fun to hunt behind great dogs. Now don't go away, because right after the break, Bill takes us to the Rolling Plains Quail Research Ranch, where we get a chance to hunt with Dale Rollins. Now Dale's also going to explain a little bit about some of the management practices for the Bob White Quail.
Outdoor Bound TV is brought to you by Real Deal Mineral and HHA Sports. Deal G2 seeds. The results speak for themselves.
Nease baits. Durable, effective, unique. The must-have fishing lures for every musky angler. Crank it, rip it, fast or slow. Our flagship Livid Fish brings them in again and again. Put trophy musky in your boat with Nease baits. Go topwater with our 10 head. From deadly slow to an all-out sprint. Nease baits. Get it done. Check us out online or pick up Nease baits at a retailer near you.
Proving yet again that the best never rest, Otter introduces Otter Thermaltech, the proprietary full thermal shell found on every 2015 Otter shelter. Beginning with the all-new XTH hub shelters and the all-new lightweight one-man XT hideout, on up to the ever-popular XT and XT Pro Series shelters that have earned a near-legendary reputation for unmatched toughness and durability. At Otter, we know stopping at good enough is way overrated. This ice season, see for yourself how the best just keep getting better.
Value Implement serves all of West Central Wisconsin and provides the tough Kubota equipment you need to tackle tough Wisconsin winters. Even the harshest weather is no match for the quality of Kubota and the experience of Value Implement's team. Take control of winter and stop in today for the largest selection of Kubota products at any of our six convenient locations. Value Implement.
More stores, more selection, more value.
You know, each year we receive thousands of photos from our viewers of animals that you've harvested and fish that you've caught, and we love to share them with you here on the show. And this year you can win some great prizes once again just for sending us your photos.
All you have to do to be eligible to win is email us your photo or share it with us on Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter.
Prizes include an assortment of musky lures from Nasebaits, a Yeti cooler from Petrick Service Station, a trip for two aboard the Grand Illusion 2 charter boat on Lake Michigan, and this year's grand prize, a 4-day, 3-night fishing vacation at Sunset Cove Resort on Lake of the Woods, Ontario.
And remember, all you have to do to be eligible to win is send us your photo with your name and your hometown.
Here are this week's Outdoor Bound TV viewer photos.
Welcome to West Texas. My name is Dale Rollins. I am the executive director of the Rolling Plains Quail Research Foundation. Our crown jewel is the Rolling Plains Quail Research Ranch, a 4,700 acre property here in Fisher County, Texas, out in West Texas. I was born and raised in southwestern Oklahoma. We had no deer, we had no turkey, we had Bob White and blue quail, and so that's what I cut my teeth on. And all through my high school and college age, bird hunted. And I've carried that love and that passion for quail ever since that time. I got my master's degree at Oklahoma State, working on Bob White and blue quail. And for the last 30 years, I've worked for Texas A&M as a wildlife specialist across West Texas. But quail have always been my personal interest. And so I've just got, that's my passion, if you will. Okay, let's go. Come on! We have permission to hunt the research ranch for three reasons. One is public relations, media. The second reason is donors. And the third reason is youth. We'll typically host two or three youth hunts for our Bob White Brigade kids and introduce them to this opera that we call quail hunting. Actually, what we're doing today is we're wanting to shoot some birds to see how many of the birds that we shoot have leg bands on them. We'll look at the percentage of the birds that we shoot and how many of those are leg banded, and then we'll get an idea of how accurate our estimates of trapping and our success at trapping has been. Each bird that we trap, and we trapped a little over 3,000 birds in November, each one of them has an individually numbered leg band. About 100 of those will have a radio transmitter on. Pretty much primo quail habitat through here. You got your broom weeds, you got some sunflowers, enough grass for nesting cover, easy for a quail to get along, sufficient brush. Where'd it go, Shaggy? Where'd that, Trace? The birds have been really wild this year as far as flushing out in front. Yeah, Shag's on point up here. Dog up in front there, Bill, gonna be coming out on your side a bit. Rookie mistake on my part. A covey of quail's basic defense is to confuse their enemy, whether that be a hawk or whatever, and it was a rookie mistake on my part because I couldn't pick a bird out. That's the most difficult thing for a novice to do, is not try to shoot the whole covey, but pick out a single bird, and it fooled me that time. Nice covey though, 20 birds or so. Come on, babe, right here. Come here. Drop it. Now then, Bill, you did good, because you shot a leg-banded bird. 1-1-6-7-2. We can look back at our records and say where this bird was trapped, when it was trapped. Odds are it was trapped this past November, probably at a bait site within 100 yards of here. Most of our quail don't travel very far. 25 acres or so is a typical home range. We've had some birds return to us from as far as 12 miles away, but we think that's a fairly small part of the population. Well, we both hit it. There you go. I'm sure glad you got that and balance a hen. After I dropped the leg, I'm sure glad you got it. Come on, Dad. Let's go. Come on, Dad. Come on. Tracer, come on. Ought to be right out in here, shouldn't it? Yeah, I'm pretty sure that bird didn't run off. And so in 2007, we had a chance. We'd spoken with some philanthropists that were interested in quail. And at that time, quail numbers were doing this all across their range. And so we spoke with them about the idea of coming up with a research ranch in West Texas. And in 2007, that became reality. It's a 4,700-acre property, managed well for Bob White Quail. So it is a laboratory that's a one-of-a-kind. There is no other property where everything points to quail like this one does out here. We've done a lot of really cool projects out here on basically all aspects of quail. Everything from predation management, hawks, coyotes, bobcats. We put radio collars on, GPS collars on bobcats and coyotes and see how they work the habitat during the nesting season. We'll monitor anywhere between 100 and 300 radio marked Bob White quail. This last November, we caught 3,100 and something quail and put leg bands on all of them. And being able to watch the ebb and flow of that population, not just for a two-year master's project, which is historically about all we know about a lot of species, but over the long haul. And seeing how the weather patterns affect that, seeing how they affect everything from the rodents to the hawks to the insects, all of those are factors in the quail equation, and we've got to become better students of how those work and interact. And then we can begin to learn, how can I tweak this knob here for Bob White's, and what's that going to do to my coyotes over here, kind of thing. And I worked all my career to recruit and train what I call students of quail, people that are interested in the long-term survival of quail and the long-term survival of quail hunters and quail hunting. Got another point over here. Easy. Good shot. Oops, I hit it hard. Watch him. Yep, he went down. Find it, Dad. Find it. Come here, Trace. Good girl. Come here. Good girl. Come here. Atta girl. Good girl. Good girl. Good rooster, Bill. Oh, crap. I knew this was going to fly over us, and I still couldn't get on him. Dad?
Hey, Tracer. Hey. Tracer.
He's going to be a low house 8-shot, and I still couldn't get on him. Basically, most of our funding comes from the users, from the hunters. We're very fortunate. There's a group in Texas called Quail Coalition, and especially the chapter in Dallas funds our operating costs. That's about $300,000 a year. Those are tough dollars to raise. We don't get state dollars, we don't get federal grants and that kind of thing. The passion of the user group, the quail hunter, is incredible. And it'd be no different for pheasants or grouse or mule deer or whatever. It's the people that are the ones that are the hunters that are funding the conservation. And that's a very powerful message. Now, I tell people, you don't have to be carrying a shotgun and following pointers to appreciate quail hunting, because when we're managing for Bob White quail, we're also managing for dick thistles, for meadowlarks. We're managing for horned lizards here in Texas, things that are never hunted, but they benefit from the dollars and the effort that we put into wildlife habitat focused on quail. So when it comes to quail, we're all a winner.
Atta girl, come on, Trace. Come on, Trace, come on, baby. Good girl, come on, atta girl, good girl, come on right here, all the way.
Atta girl,
good girl.
Get her off.
Outdoor Bound TV is brought to you by Brewpub Pizza and Nays Baits.
Brewpub Pizza is specifically designed with the hungry in mind. It's big, it's bold, and it's outrageously delicious. Brewpub Lotsa Matzo Pizza is made with your favorite premium meats and veggies, topped with over a half pound of real Wisconsin mozzarella cheese. When you're looking for the ultimate pizza adventure, when you crave a really serious pizza that brings the great Brewpub experience, this is the one. Pick it up today at your favorite local grocer. Brewpub Lotsa Matzo Pizza, the ingredients for a great time.
We handle your races, your jumps, and your trails. Isn't it time you give your daily driver the same love? AMSOIL's Signature Series Synthetic Motor Oil delivers 75% more engine protection against horsepower loss and wear than required by a leading industry standard. AMSOIL also offers a full family of snowmobile lubricants, giving you above and beyond fortification for your weekday and weekend vehicles.
Order direct online at qcamsoil.myamsoil.com.
Markham Technologies unleashes GPS with the release of the RT9, the first to combine sonar, underwater camera, and navionics mapping in a 9-inch ruggedized touchscreen tablet. Built on the Android operating system, the Wi-Fi-enabled RT9 can be used as a standalone tablet or snap into the cradle or performance pack for unmatched portability. Ice Electronics, the way they were meant to be. Sonar, GPS, underwater camera, one unit. Experience the RT9 from Markham Technologies.
Nearly 70 years ago, a simple idea was taking form in the heart of the Ice Belt. That idea was, if you combined a commitment to quality with a passion for the sport of ice fishing, you could build a better ice auger. From that idea, StrikeMaster was born. Forever committed to innovation in the quest to build a lighter, more durable auger. StrikeMaster, powerful, durable, reliable.
Outdoor Bound TV is brought to you by the W.C. Russell Moccasin Company and Golden Hawk Canoes.
I'm telling you, this has been a ton of fun quail hunting here in West Texas. I'd like to thank my hosts, Bill and Gail High, and of course, Dale Rollins here at the Quail Research Ranch. It's been a ton of fun. Folks, join us again here next week. We'll bring you more great hunting and fishing action from around the Midwest, around the nation, and around the world, right here on Outdoor Bound TV. I need to practice.
Welcome you viewers to West Texas and...
Well, that's a wrap from here in West Texas. I'd like to thank my hosts.
Outdoors or outward bound? More shells, more shells. I kept wanting to say outward bound and so outdoor bound, okay. Thanks for joining us in West Texas. Now we're going to... Mm-hmm.